A very blessed morning to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ.
弟兄姐妹们，愿你们都得到上帝的祝福。
It is such a joy for me to be back at TA Church.
这是非常感谢主让我能够回到母堂直落牙医礼拜堂。
It feels like coming home.
就好像已经回到我的娘家那一般。
Just now when we were worshiping and singing songs, my mind took me back to the days when I was in Sunday school.
刚才我们在唱诗的时候，我就回想到当年我在直落牙医堂主入学的那个光景。
And the person in front telling story is Prof. Tan.I have not told him before, but his stories were very exciting.
谢谢郑牧师的夸奖。
Well, today I bring you warmest greetings from Trinity Theological College.
在这里我代表上一神学院呢，向大家来致安。
Thank you for remembering.The Ministry of TTC.
谢谢你们今年三一神学院的施工。
TA Church has been a very strong supporter of TTC.
直落牙医堂一向来都是非常挺立的支持三一神学院。
TA supported me when I first taught at TTC 10 years ago in the year 2013.
在2013年，直落牙医堂支持我来进入了三一神学院来做讲师。
It was the Reverend C. Ping Ik who connected me with TTC and with the support of this church helped to open the door of ministry at the seminary.
当时就是施天一牧师来让我联系三一神学院，让我有机会来进入三一神学院来执教。
And today, TA continues to support TTC in a very significant way.
今天直落牙医堂继续仍旧非常支持三一神学院这样的一个施工。
Reverend Timothy Ang is now a faculty in development at TTC.
你们大家所熟悉的这个洪佩正牧师也就是三一神学院所要预备将来装备成为三一神学院的教职员。
And you have partnered TTC to support Reverend Ang in his doctoral studies at Aberdeen University.
那么你们直落牙医堂就是跟三一神学院一起共同来支持洪牧师，让他能够在这个阿伯丁神学院大学来读这个神学博士。
So God willing, eventually you will have two members of in the past of a TA church serving at TTC on faculty.
所以你们将来就是直落牙医堂将会有两位会友在三一神学院来做这个讲员。
Myself and of course Reverend.
就是郑牧师、郑博士以及。
So on behalf of TTC, I would like to express our deepest thanks and appreciation to your strong support.
所以在此我要代表三一神学院来向大家来谢谢会堂给我们的支持。
This year, TTC celebrates our 75th anniversary.
今年三一神学院庆祝75周年。
Various events have been organized since the start of this year to celebrate God's goodness and faithfulness through the ministry of our college.
就从今年开始，我们就有各种不同的节目来庆祝这个三一神学院的这个周年庆典。
Our celebration climaxed last Friday with a Thanksgiving service in the morning and a dinner in the evening.
那么庆典的高潮就是到上个星期五，我们早上有一个感恩的崇拜，那晚上有一个晚宴。
And our college has also produced a special video to introduce the ministry of TTC for our 75th anniversary celebration.
三一神学院也预备了一个视频来纪念过去75年这个施工。
May I invite the technical crew to just put up the video?
我请后面的工作人员来帮我们把这个视频来播出来。
We are committed to the church. TTC is of the church and for the church. We are committed to the authority of Scripture and rigorous theological scholarship. We are committed to spiritual formation, seeking to inculcate in our students a heart for God. We are committed to Christian engagement in the public square in our witness for Christ. We are committed to the church in Singapore and in Asia and beyond. We are Trinity Theological College.
Lux Mundi.
Well, that's our crest that you just saw.
这就是我们, 神学院的这个徽章,
and our motto is Lux Mundi in Latin.
就是拉丁文,
which means light of the world.
就是成为世界的光,
that is our aspiration as a seminary.
这就是我们成为神学院的所样的这个期望,
we want to exalt Jesus Christ, the light of the world.
我们要支持我们的主耶稣基督是世界的光,
and we want to do that in everything that we do, from teaching to our life together as a community.
所以我们不但是在教导方面，是在生活方面来彰显耶稣基督。
So do continue to remember to pray for us.
所以请你们继续的来支持，为我们来代祷。
We have a difficult task ahead because the challenges are great for the future.
我们前面还有许多的挑战。
There are many challenges on the front of the ethics or politics or economics. We require biblical and theological thinking.
所以我们不同，不论在伦理方面、政治方面，以及教育方面，有各同的要以上帝的真理来做这样的教导。
And we appreciate your continued support.
我们也继续的请你们继续的为我们来代祷和支持。
Well, now we have come to this juncture to receive from God His message for us this morning.
那时候，这时候我们来接受上帝的话语。
Let's bow in prayer.
让我们一起祷告。
Heavenly Father, may the light of your holy word instruct us.
天父上帝，愿你圣灵的光来照耀我们。
May the power of your eternal truth renew us.
愿你那永恒的真理来照耀我们。
And may your Holy Spirit empower us for the living of these days.
愿你圣灵给我们的力量，能够来面临今天的日子。
We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
奉耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
Amen. All of humanity's problems stem from our inability to sit quietly in a room alone.
所有的人类的问题就是不能够安静地单独在一个房间里面。
These are the words of the 17th century French mathematician and philosopher Blaise Pascal.
这是十七世纪的一位法国的数学家以及哲学家帕斯卡所说的话。
Let me repeat the quote again.
让我再重复他所说的话。
All of humanity's problems stem from our inability to sit quietly in a room alone.
所有人类的问题就是他们不能够单独的在安静的在一个房间里面。
Now, those of you who are more introverted like me will find that these words of Pascal sound like music to our ears.
那些内向的人就像我那样，会当我们听到巴斯卡所说的话，就好像是个非常悦耳的一个音乐，很动听的一个音乐。
In a world that places so much emphasis on being outgoing and being on the ball, finally, here is someone who seems to understand me.
那么对这个世界非常注重那个活力、有动力的这样的人群的。的人来说呢，这句话似乎是对那些内向的人是一个很有动听的一个话语。
In fact, Pascal seems to be speaking up for introverts.
就好像是帕斯卡是向那些内向的人来说这样的话语。
So when I first came across these words of his, I was very pleased.
所以当我听到帕斯卡所说的这句话的时候，我感到非常高兴。
I copied the words on my WhatsApp chat and I sent them to my wife, Angela.Who is an extrovert?
所以当我听到这个话语之后呢，我把它拷贝之后寄给我的太太。她是一个非常外向的人。
And after sending the words, I checked the quotation in its context and realized that I had misinterpreted Pascal.
但是当我把这个话语寄出去给我太太之后呢，我在看参考它的上下文等等，我发现其实我误解了帕斯卡所说的话。
Pascal wasn't referring to the advantage of being an introvert.
其实帕斯卡并不是来说那些内向的人有什么的优势。
He was in fact offering a diagnosis of the world in his day.
其实他是对当年的他那个社会里面的社会的世界所做的这样一个判断和诊断。
And his diagnosis is prophetic.
他所做的这个诊断呢，就好像是一个有预言性的。
It has a significant insight into the world even in our day.
他对从当年到现在，他几乎对这个世界有一个非常的洞察力。
According to Pascal, there is a restlessness of soul in humanity.
根据帕斯卡，就是说在人的心灵当中有一个非常不能够安定的那这个心态。
We never seem to be at rest.
因为我们好像就不能够在那里安静的下来。
We are always busying ourselves with something.
因为我们就好像不时地为着这个世界在繁忙。
And should we have time on our hands, we will fill it up with entertainment.
所以当我们有空闲的时候呢，我们就要找一些消遣、一些娱乐的东西来填补这些的空缺。
And Pascal calls these entertainment diversions.
所以帕斯卡就说这样的消遣呢，这样的或者这种的娱乐呢，是一种的消除烦恼。
Activities such as hunting and gambling were common diversions in Pascal's day.
在当年巴斯卡的时代呢，所谓消除烦恼的这些活动，就包括去打猎啦，或者去赌博。
And in our day, we have multiplied them.
到今年到现在，我们的世界里面呢，增加更多的这种消除烦恼的这个动作。
Today we have gambling, of course, but we have other entertainment as well.
今天我们也同样也有赌博，但是我们有更多其他的这样的活动。
There's shopping.
比如说去购物。
Scrolling on our Facebook and Instagram.
或者在电脑这个脸书的上面呢，来浏览。
Checking out the number of likes on our social media posts.
看你所里面的那个赞有多少个这个赞点。
And also queuing up overnight for tickets to Taylor Swift concerts.
或者在那里排队彻夜的排队来购买那个 Taylor Swift 女歌手的演唱会的门票。
Why do we busy ourselves with such activities when we have the time?
为什么我们为了这些事情来繁忙呢？虽然我们有时间。
Pascal says it's not because we find ultimate happiness in them.
Pascal 说并不是因为我们从中得到那种满足感。
It is because they are able to distract us from the painful truth about ourselves.
因为它其实是让我们来逃离现实，来面对我们自己内心的忧伤。
We will do anything and everything in our restlessness except sitting quietly in a room alone.
我们在不同的这种不安的情况之下呢，我们不能安静的下来寻找。
For when we are alone, we have to face ourselves.
因为当我们单独存在的单独在房间里面呢，我们要面对我们自己。
We are confronted with the truth of who we are.
我们要面对我们自己到底是谁的这样的一个现实。
That we are but mortals who will one day pass away.
我们只不过是凡人，有一天我们要离开这个世界。
Deep down, we know it and we feel it.
在我们内心里面，我们清楚了解我们自己。
Our work and our divergence do not give us that deep inward rest of soul.
这世界上所谓的那些消遣、那些消除烦恼的事情，没有办法来满足我们内心的那个要求。
Whether we agree with Pascal or not, he has put his finger on a common human experience.
不论我们是同意 Pascal 所说的话与否呢，但是我们都同样承认我们有需要这样的一个寻求内心的安定。
Humanity.Is searching for rest.
因为人类就在那里寻找内心的这个平静安息。
Rest from the burdens of our sins and guilt.
就从我们的罪恶与我们的内疚感来得到解脱而得到安息。
Rest from oppression and evil.
对那个迫害以及罪恶的当中来得到释放而得到安息。
Rest from our anxieties and our fear of death.
对我们的烦恼，对我们的内心的恐惧来得到解脱而得到安息。
I don't know what your life situation is today as we gather in this sanctuary to worship God. 我们
天天聚集在这里的时候，我们内心的状况是如何呢？
But don't be surprised if we find ourselves longing and searching for rest in our hearts.
你不需要惊讶，因为大家都同样的在那里，在内心都要不平安，在那里要寻求安息。
Rest.From having to prove ourselves to others that we are good enough.
就是我们要有一种内心的要求，说我们比别人更好，来当中的这种压力当中来得到安息。
Rest from our search for significance.
从我们要来得到人家的赞赏的当中来得到解脱而得到安息。
In our gospel reading today, Jesus offers rest.For burdened souls.
今天耶稣基督在这个经文里面，让我们得到一个保障，怎么样来得到心灵的安息
？In verses 28 to 30, Jesus says, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest."
从28节到29节，他说，烦恼苦担重担的人，可以到我这里来，我就给你得到安息。
Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart.And you will find rest for your souls.
你要负我的轭，背负我的重担，因为我是心里柔和谦卑的，你会得到心里的安息。
For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
因为我的轭是容易的，我的担子是轻省的。
And this morning, I want to call attention to two things involved in this rest that Jesus offers.
所以今天我要跟大家来探两点，耶稣所要给予我们这样的安息是什么呢
？The first is this: Jesus says.Come to me.
第一点就是耶稣说，来到我这里来。
If we want rest for our burdened souls, Jesus says, "Come to me."
耶稣说，如果你要到心灵得到安息的话，来到我这里来。
Not come to an ethical principle.
并不是来到一个伦理的一些原则。
Not come to a concept or an idea.
或者不是关于一些概念或者一些的思想。
But come to the very person of Jesus Christ.
而是来到耶稣基督的面前。
The immediate context clarifies for us who we are coming to if we come to Jesus for rest.
如果我们看到上下文，就可能清楚了解耶稣所说的到底他是谁。
The focus of the immediate context is on the person of Jesus.
因为在这个上下文里面，我们看到耶稣基督本身他是怎么样的一个人。
And so in verse 27, Jesus says, "All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son." And anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal Him.
第二十七节就是要告诉我们说，耶稣说，天父已经把这一切都交给我，除了父，没有人知道子；除了子，以这子所愿意启示的，没有人能够知道父。
Jesus, the one who invites us to come, is.The very center of God's revelation.
Yeah, 耶稣基督他来对我们这样的邀请呢，他本身就是上帝本身的一个中心点。
Jesus is the Son of God.
耶稣基督是上帝的儿子。
He is the perfect image of the invisible God.
他是看不见的上帝的一个完美的形象。
Only Jesus alone is able to reveal who God truly is.
就是只有主耶稣本身能够清楚的表明上帝是谁。
For burdened souls who are seeking rest.From their restless search for God, Jesus says, "Come to me."
对那些心里受重担的人，要寻求安息的人，耶稣说：“来到我这里。”
He is the only one who knows God fully and reveals God clearly.
因为只有耶稣基督清楚的认识上帝是谁，清楚的了解我们的上帝。
The broader context of Jesus' offer of rest also focuses on the identity of Jesus.
除了我们唱更广的这个。 背景的时候呢，更了解耶稣基督他的本身，他的身份。
Matthew is extremely intentional with his material.
特别我们在马太福音里面看到作者马太刻意的来描画这个事情。
At the start of Matthew chapter 11, John the Baptist was in prison.
在十一章的前半部，我们看到这个施洗约翰被囚禁在监牢里面。
He sent his disciples to ask Jesus a question.
他就害怕的派了门徒去问耶稣一个问题。
In verse 3, we read, "Are you the one who is to come, or shall we look for another?"
第三节是说，你是不是那是我们所等待的呢？还是我们在等另外一个位？
In other words, are you the Messiah?
换句话说，你到底是不是弥赛亚呢？
Now the question of John the Baptist raises a very important issue that was being debated at that time all throughout Galilee.
施洗约翰当时所问的这个问题，就是当年在加利利一带的人所问众所问的同样一个问题。
Who really is this Jesus who has been healing the sick and casting out demons?
到底这位耶稣是谁呢？他能够一并赶鬼，到底这耶稣是谁？
Who is this Jesus who makes the blind see and the lame walk?
到底这耶稣是谁呢？他给瞎子看见，瘸子能够行走。
Who is this Jesus who is able to command the winds and the waves?
到底耶稣是谁呢？他能够指使风和浪。
Now, many people in the day of John the Baptist debated the question about Jesus' identity.
当施洗约翰那个时代，就是很多人在那里争论到底耶稣是谁。
Because of his miracles.
就是因为他们看到耶稣所行的神迹。
But not John the Baptist.
但是施洗约翰没有在那里争论。
John the Baptist knew the answer.
因为施洗约翰清楚知道那个答案。
As early as Matthew chapter 3, when Jesus came to John to be baptized, this is what John said to him.
就是在马太福音第三章的时候，当耶稣来到施洗约翰跟前要受洗的时候，
John says to Jesus, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?"
施洗约翰对耶稣说，是我应该被你受洗，为什么你来到我这里呢？
You see, John clearly knew that Jesus was the Messiah.
因为施洗约翰清楚知道耶稣基督就是弥赛亚。
But because he was imprisoned by Herod Antipas, he was undergoing pain and suffering.
就是因为这个时候呢，他在这个西利安提波王的这个囚禁之下呢，他心里开始有动摇了。
And he was now discouraged and began to doubt the identity of Jesus.
这时候他心里非常的灰心，他开始在怀疑耶稣基督。
Isn't the Messiah supposed to be the one who will baptize with the Spirit and fire and bring about God's judgment?
难道耶稣基督不是要来到这里来施行神迹的话来？
Why was Jesus healing and blessing instead of judging evil oppressors like Herod?
为什么耶稣基督来施行这些神迹医病赶鬼，但而不去来惩罚这个恶者安提波王呢？
Are you the one who is to come, Jesus, or should we look for another?
难道你不是我们所等待的呢？还是我们要再等待另外一位弥赛亚？
Now this question is extremely unexpected.
这样的问题是好像几乎所不能够意料到的。
In chapter 11, verse 11, Jesus says, "Among those born of women, there has not risen anyone greater than John the Baptist."
在十一章十一节里，耶稣说，除了从妇女所生下来的这些，没有一位能够大过施洗约翰。比他更大的一个先，成为一个先知。
Up till then, John was the greatest of the prophets.
到那个时候来为止呢，施洗约翰是个最伟大的一个先知。
But for all his courage and commitment, John wavered in his hour of trial.
但是虽然施洗约翰行了这么多的这样的事情，在那个时候他信心动摇了。
Elijah was persecuted by Queen Jezebel, and he wanted to die.
那个以利亚先知，当他面临这个耶洗别王后的时候呢，他本身也在寻求死亡。
The Elijah who was to come, John the Baptist, was also persecuted, and he doubted the identity of Jesus.
圣经告诉我们，施洗约翰就是将来要来的那个以利亚，但这个时候他受到这个逼害。
The truth is that the best of men are but men at best.
所以我们看到那个最好的人，到底最后还只不过是人而已。
This was true of John, and this is true of all of us who serve the Lord.
这对施洗约翰是真实的，对我们这些人也是同样是真实的。
Are you undergoing trials in your life?
你是否在生命中遇到不同的挑战呢？
And are you calling into question all that God has meant to you all these years?
你是不是对上帝来提出这过去许多年来你所提出的这些问题呢？
If you are, you are not alone.
如果你是的话呢，你不是唯一的。
John doubted in times of severe trial as well. But he came to Jesus even when he doubted. And Jesus did not reject John when he sent his disciples to Jesus with questions about his identity.
的门徒来到耶稣的跟前，耶稣没有拒绝他的问题。
Firmly and with compassion, Jesus guided him with the scriptures in response.
耶稣很有坚定的，而且有慈爱的来把用圣经的话语来回答使徒约翰的问题。
Brothers and sisters, when we are burdened by trying circumstances in our life and ministry, and we find ourselves weak and wavering, the invitation of Jesus remains open to all of us.
弟兄姐妹，当我们来在我们的生活中或者在我们的事工上，我们有这些的怀疑的时候呢，耶稣基督他不会拒绝我们。
He says to you and to me, come to me.
他会跟我们来说，来到我这里来。
Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
患劳苦担重担的人可以来到我这里来。
Jesus didn't turn John away when John came to him with his doubts.
当使约翰来到耶稣的跟前，耶稣没有拒绝他。
And he will not turn us away if we go to him with our struggles.
所以同样，当我们来到耶稣的跟前，耶稣不会拒绝我们。
So firstly, come to me.
所以第一个第一点就是来到我这里来。
Secondly, Jesus says, take my yoke.
第二点就是耶稣说背负我的轭。Verse 29 to 30.
Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls.
背负我的轭子，学我的样式，你就会心里得到安息。For
my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
因为我的
Now we must not be mistaken about the rest that Jesus offers.
但我们不要误解耶稣所说的这个安息。
Jesus is not offering a rest that is without obligations.
耶稣所给我们这样的安息不是不需要说不需要付代价的。
There is a yoke that we need to take on if we are to find rest.
因为我们必须要来背负这样的一个轭来以追求这样的一个安息。
And that yoke is the easy yoke of Christ.
这个耶稣所说的轭是一个容易的轭。Now
literally, the yoke is the wooden collar that ran across the shoulders of a pair of oxen.
这个轭，所谓的轭呢，就是横跨两只牛背上的一个木质的一个框架。It
enables the oxen to pull enormous weights together.
让这两只牛能够背负一个重量重的担子。Metaphorically,
the yoke was used to describe the Old Testament law or the Torah.
从比喻的观点呢，这个轭在当年是来比喻犹太人的这个律法。The
Jews were required to submit to the authority of the law.
犹太人需要来服从、来跟从这些的这个律法。But
Jewish leaders had interpreted the law in such a way that weighed the people down with all their additional rules and regulations.
但是犹太的宗教领袖们就来误解了这个。
In Matthew chapter 23, Jesus warns his disciples about it.
在马太福音23节，耶稣就是这样的警告他的门徒。
Referring to the scribes and Pharisees, he says in chapter 23, verse 4, they tie up heavy burdens, hard to bear, and lay them on people's shoulders, but they themselves are not willing to move them with their finger.
那耶稣跟他们就说，这些文士、法利赛人，他们就是把重担加在人的身上，但是他们本身自己不愿意动一个指头。Jesus
is unlike the Pharisees and the scribes.
耶稣跟这些文士、法利赛人是不同的。And
his yoke is different.
因为他的轭是不同的。It is a
yoke of discipleship with Jesus as our teacher.
因为这样的轭是一个跟耶稣做同做门徒，耶稣做我们的导师。Not
the discipleship that the scribes and the Pharisees represent.
并不是文士和法利赛人所说的这样的一个轭。
To take the yoke of Jesus means to submit to the authority of his teaching.
就是当我们背负耶稣的轭的时候呢，就是我们来降服耶稣所给我们的这个教导。
It means to learn from him how to live as his disciple.
就是要来学习怎么样来做耶稣基督的门徒。
Learn how to live the life that Jesus wants us to live.
就是要来过耶稣所要我们过的这样的一个生活。
His yoke is easy not because it makes lighter demands in his teaching.
他的这个轭是轻容易的，并不表示说他给我们非常容易的一些事情做。
But because of the character of Jesus.
乃是因为耶稣本身的这个特性。
Jesus is gentle and lowly in heart.
因为耶稣是温柔与谦卑的。
And in his gentleness, he will not yoke us to a burden beyond what we can bear.
所以他因为他是温柔的，他不会给我们非常的重担，以致我们不能够承担。
In his humility, he became a servant to bear the weight of sin and guilt that we were meant to bear.
他是谦卑的，所以他能够成为一个仆人，来跟我们分担这样的一个重担。
If we want rest for our souls, Jesus says, "Come to me and take my yoke."
所以耶稣告诉我们，如果我们要得到安息，就是来到耶稣的跟前，并且背负耶稣的轭。
Many want to lose their burden, but they don't want to take on the yoke of Jesus.
许多时候，人要卸下这些重担，但是他们不愿意来背负耶稣的这个轭。
We cannot have one without the other.If we want to find rest for our souls.
我们要真正的要这样安息，我们不能够顾此失彼。
The rest that Jesus gives is not a life of careless ease.
耶稣所告诉我们，这个安息不是一个没有目的、漫不经心的这样的一个生活。
It is a life that is yoked to Jesus Christ.
因为这样的一个生活是跟耶稣同负一轭的生活。
It is a life lived in the freedom of obedience to Him and the joy of service for Him.
这是一个跟从耶稣而得到自由，并且在服侍耶稣基督当中而得到这样的一个喜乐。
It is a life whose labor is energized by the love of God and the love of Christ.
这样的一个生活呢，就是因为耶稣基督所，因为我们爱耶稣基督而得到这样的一个力量。
It is a life whose pace is our master's pace.
这样的一个生活呢，就是跟耶稣基督能够同样同步的来进行。
In the words of the Christian author Eugene Peterson, it is a life characterized by what he calls.The unforced rhythms of grace.
有一位基督教的作者叫 Eugene Peterson， 他就说是一个好像不是在那里勉强的恩典的节奏。
Let me repeat that: the unforced rhythms of grace.
是一个不受勉强的恩典的节奏。
There is a rhythm. Your life is regulated by the life of Christ.
在我们的生命当中有这样的一个节奏来。来调整我们的生活。
And you take it on freely and willingly. It is not imposed or forced.
所以我们在耶稣基督的生命里面呢，能够自由的生活，而不是在那里受压制、受勉强。
And every day your life is sustained by grace.
那么每一天的生活就是上帝的恩典来支持我们。
The unforced rhythms of grace.
所以这就是所谓的不受勉强的恩典的节奏。
Allow me to end with Eugene Peterson's paraphrase of verses 28 to 30.
让我用 Peter Peterson 他所讲 Eugene Peterson 他在这个二十九到三十节里面，他用另外一种话语来解释这段的经文。
Are you tired?
你疲倦吗
？Worn out?
你是精疲力倦呢、啊、
？Burnt out on religion?
为了这个宗教而感到疲倦。
Come to me.
来到我这里。
Get away with me, and you will recover your life.
跟我一起的步行，那么你会重新得到你的生命。
I will show you how to take a real rest.
我要让你知道怎么样得到真正的安息。
Walk with me and work with me.
跟我同步，跟我同工。
Watch how I do it.
看我怎么样来做。
Learn the unforced rhythms of grace.
来学习那个不受勉强的恩典的步骤。
I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting for you.
我不会给你非常大的重担，以致你不能够承受。
Keep company with me.
跟我一起同步进行。
And you will learn to live freely and lightly.
那这样你就能够自由的，而且很轻松的跟我一起来同行。
Is there anyone here who is longing?This morning, for your sins to be forgiven.
今天你们在座当中，是不是你有心灵希望你的罪恶能够得到赦免吗
？The Apostle Peter says in 1 Peter 2:24, Jesus bore our sins in His body on the tree.
保罗这样讲说，耶稣基督被挂在十字架上，为亲身担当我们的罪。
Is there anyone here who is yearning for an identity because you cannot accept yourself for who you are？
是你们当中是不是有人要为自己来问自己到底我是谁呢？因为你们不能够接受你自己的身份。
The author to the Hebrews in chapter 2 verse 11 assures us that Jesus is not ashamed to call us brothers and sisters。
希伯来书的作者告诉我们说，耶稣基督称我们为兄弟姐妹，他本身不会感到羞耻。
Are you ashamed to come to Christ because of your failures?
你是不是因为你过去的失败而感到羞耻来到耶稣基督的跟前呢？
You think that Jesus will never receive you anymore because of what you have done?
是不是你过去所做的这一切，你感觉到耶稣不能够接受你呢？
Jesus says in John chapter 6 verse 37, "Whoever comes to me, I will never drive out."
所以耶稣基督在约翰福音第六章第七节说，你凡是来到我这里，我从不会拒绝你们。
Do you feel abandoned? And alone,
你是不是感到被弃绝，感到非常孤单呢？
The Apostle Paul declares that nothing in all creation is able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
也是，保罗这样说，在一切受造之物，没有任何的事物能够让我们离开耶稣基督的恩的爱。
Jesus holds a rest for all our restlessness.
也是就是有那个要给我们所有的需要的那个安息。
If you have come into God's house today with restless and burdened hearts, Jesus promises rest for burdened souls.
如果你到上帝的圣殿里面带着不安，带着苦难，耶稣基督他要应许你那个安息。
And he says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened." And I will give you rest.
他说：“凡劳苦担重担的来到这里，我给你得到安息。”
Take my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls.
背负我的轭，学我的样式，你就会心里得到安息，因为我的心里都温和谦卑。你要我的担是我的轭是容易的，我的担是轻省的。
Are you willing to come to Jesus today?
你是否愿意来到耶稣的跟前
？Are you willing?To take up the yoke of Jesus and learn from him again how to live that abundant life that he intends for you to live.
你是否愿意来背负耶稣基督的轭，来学耶稣基督的样式，来过着耶稣所要应许你的那个丰盛的生命？
May we begin this week from a place of restedness in Christ.
那我们这个礼拜里面就从那个我们心里的这个不安的这个世界当中。
And may God help us to keep company with.Jesus.
愿主帮助我们，让我们跟耶稣基督同行，同伴在一起。
And learn to live freely and lightly.
而且能够学习，能够很自由的、很轻省的过我们的生活。
Amen.
Amen.
Let's take a moment of quietness just to respond to God's word.
让我们安静我们的心来回应。